All right, everyone, welcome back to episode 2. Hi, Garth Paul. welcome back to episode 2 of LEGO Star Wars Complete Saga. Let's do episode 2. I might do a little free play this episode, I'm not sure. In any case. Story mode, go. This level, I'm probably just going to blow my mind at once, because I'm going to have, there's a lot of areas that you can't access without, like, without the improvements and stuff like that. So. Definitely can be a lot worse, but you're maneuvering in tight quarters like this and it's getting strange. One thing I've always wondered, where is Obi-Wan in all this? If he If you see him bolt, don't get the speed of him. Yeah. He's just hard. I guess he didn't trust Anakin to work that, but this one too. There's a lot of vehicle sections in this game that are like this. All the same general. And that's not a... I'm not going to say that's necessarily bad, but you can call it competitive. Okay. See, okay, wait. Understand, the controls are based on the direction... They're not based on what direction the thing is going. They're based on the direction the camera is going. Combined with the fact that you like suddenly turn on like that, if there isn't anyone to turn hideous, that's a few bad. Rather awful sometimes. Maybe it can bounce. Oh, it's going for half. Does it just mean it was shit like only half health? Didn't seem like I killed him. Anyway, it's done. Gather up a bunch of studs and then head inside. I'm from Washington, so the rain doesn't bother me. Platform off one of these platforms you could boost to over to, but right now I'm going to discontinue with the mission. Just show her the poison gun. Totally won't blow your concept here. I guess Obi-Wan is not a spy here. What is he, an investigator? Either way, way to show your hand. Okay, I doubt that I never noticed this, but I just never appreciated it. The fact that the droid socket shows R4's silhouette since you're obviously with him for this one. It gets me thinking, like, does that mean that in free play mode, if you choose a different astromech, it'll... One of the longest, I don't want to call them gags, I'm thinking of the Simpsons that are on the level. These aren't level games, but they're interactive elements. One of the longest interactable elements. This is that room that you push all the way around the corridor. Just like every level, has like its own interactable, like its own duplicate. I'm not gonna say duplicate, but its own staple color. These buttons are weird. Tricky, now I'm not sure. Oh, I guess I was thinking of a different one. There's one of these where it's like super tight on timing. Just, it gives you like just enough time to run through and get all of that's another bounty hunting only area, so. Should I do the puzzle on the other side? I'll just continue on with the level. Puzzle was mostly just designed to make you learn about blocking shots with his lightsaber. To the washing machine, which is really just an exit. I know there's supposed to be this like intense chase sequence going on, but nah, I'd rather just be slower. Exactly how much the blast radius those things have, so I just don't quite say it. Oh. this is the room, I think. I remember. Where those droids will... Yeah, those... They will infinitely respawn. You can't have a droid of Obi-Wan. You have to use Obi-Wan to distract them. Those are four of them. This level's kind of short. I was talking about with the remembering sets from this. This is one of the primary samples. I actually had the same set, except it was Bulbous, the red one. I think that last bit of cutscene would have been more fitting at the beginning of the next level, but... Eh. This is another one of those levels that I remember to be. I don't remember mechanically pretty well, but I remember the theming pretty well. Got to 7. One of my favorite designs in Star Wars, actually. All right. More interactable, but trigger my ADHD. I don't actually have ADHD. I know there's a puzzle you can do in here, but I'm gonna move on. Forgot about that. But there's another one. Giving me money for keeping the factory machine running. She just got crushed by thing. You'll see that a lot in this battle. Other actually, no, that button doesn't actually, or that droid socket doesn't actually do it. Just, it just stops the bees where you get secrets and stuff. Whoa, we need to get fun. Oh, there's a door. That's probably not one of my smarter ones. I think you can jump. There are ones you can't. I don't think that one. Pushing off. Oh, you can't. Okay. Thank you. all the droids are may look. I don't think these things are actually. I know that they're standing on the other side of the box. If you actually need this complete level. Oh yeah, there it is. But I can't jump. I don't know. Thought that was okay. And this is one of those side ones. Oh, it's this. It's like one of those mazes. Oh, this is for power, too. Remember, this being for the mini, not for the power. Alright, that's the business. That was definitely worth it. Parts where, okay, your most challenging parts are going to be parts like that, like perspective, enemy. To what is, if I remember right, the last room. Yeah, this is basically the last room. Yeah. Immediately shut these two things off. Wait, are these not the ones that spawn droids? No, that's the one that spawns. Objective. Okay. You have to use that to... I want to say it's a gas container or something to load. Trying to give you a more fair fight. You avoid me. Studs actually might be a useful investment. I love to see how much the power bricks are. I figure out. I remember them being pretty expensive some of them. Right, because I just remembered the level after this was one of my least favorite in the game. So. Levels where it's very quick if you just blast through it, but it's, I remember, it's a bit annoying to get 100% on it. Give it a shot. I've mostly fan of, like, I can appreciate the story, but I'm mostly a fan of Star Wars, specifically for the starships. I have far more specific stories of ships, their designs, than I need the actual character series. So, like, in my forte is the sci-fi series. And really all the ship designs. And the design and the design. And I guess it would be disingenuous if they don't care about the characters and they have just more knowledge than they have of the ship. At some point, I should do a character. At some point, I should do a video showcasing my miniatures. I have a collection of Star Wars X-Men miniatures, which is a game of tabletop miniatures. This next mission is among my least favorite, and definitely among my least favorite. Definitely my least favorite category. Where you basically have to drag a bunch of stupid rolling bombs across terrain into targets. There's a couple of missions like this, like that, and I'm not a fan of any. Proton torpedo, gathering proton torpedoes, dragging things down. Kind of. Yeah. Anyway, they're not terrible, but let's just get. Edition. I just destroyed that thing by plowing it. Oh, and I just had a fire on it. I did not know you could actually destroy structures by hand. Not that that's the best. Anyway. And by the way, you can't ever... One of the other things that makes Starship Flying awkward, you can't ever go to zero speed. You will always be in some... Which I guess is part of what makes this not super easy. Not super brokenly easy. It's a... Especially with how... As for these, okay, I love the best way I can think of these missions in my life. Like, I watched another YouTube channel called Jared Hayden Dragon. He described the way that he described the monorail section, the tram track section. I described it as being like an escort quest with non-symmetric object, but it's kind of what this feels like. Yeah, you did see that right. Those some droids on some levels are specifically designed to interfere. Some droids on some levels are specifically designed to get in your way and interfere with the bomb. Makes sense, right? We'll change that down to another one. I've been so negative this mission, but it's just very like. end now. Now we have the final boss fight with Duke, which is interesting. Since this episode has been kind of shorter than the previous one, I'm going to go back and do some replay on this last mission. So I'm mostly just going to focus on the paddle portion. I can come back and explore. This is a lot, this section is a lot like Dark Falls, right? Where you have grab objects, throw it back as he throws with you. right. I actually forgot Super Story was a thing. I remember what it is. Before I move on to episode 3, I'm going to do some free play with the first, with episode 1 and possibly episode 2. So. Again, stop by the shop here. We need Speeder and smoke is not odd. Ish. You know, it's in comparison, so let's. But these are, by the way, what you can do. I think this is only in free play, but I've only ever used it in free play. But if you, if you go to one of these levels, let me just go back to part one free play. You know what I'm going to do? Extras. Let's see, you can actually. Turn on these different abilities. Let's say. Exploding Blaster Bolt on. So now if you go back. Your bolt explode. You can make yourself ridiculously overpowered with it. It's fun nonetheless. It's fun nonetheless. We adjust the team. And just instantly get blown up. Get out of my way. That's strange.
Oh,
Okay, that's where the mini kit's supposed to be. I don't think I've told you this run yet, but when you reach, you get to a place where a mini kit was, that you already picked up. It's just a blue stud. Interrupt your little breakfast meeting. Okay. Here. Not sure if that's the official way that you get it. Remember this puzzle. I know we're the last one. So, why not then? I think the only thing I have left to do in this level is Superstorm, which is a the time trial test.
Thank you.
super gone. And first mini kit of the series. They get you a lot of. Alright, so there's your introduction to free play mode. I'm probably going to be doing a lot more of it as we continue on, but for now, I will leave it off here, probably with part whatever this is. And I'll see you for the next part, where we will do episode 3.